What is going on, everybody? We are at that point of the week again where we get the new episode previews given to us by the official Bleach website, so I won't be talking about any screenshots that may come out past this point, and it's going to be a bit of an interesting one. So if you enjoy these type of videos, please click the like and subscribe button. It does help out the video, and of course watch time does as well. Other than that, let's get into it, shall we? So this episode is going to be called the Shooting Star Project, and from what I've been looking through the chapters, I'm going to guess this is going to be about a 4-chapter episode yet again. Now the interesting thing about this episode, which before I even get into the images as a whole, I just want to give my quick little thoughts about generally what I think of this episode and how it's going to plan out. I think because of the high highs of episode 6 and the emotional highs and surprised highs of that of episode 7, it's only natural that we actually take a bit of a breather. All of this war has happened, they've all reverted back, and it's back to kind of a breathing period. And if you've read the manga, you would know what I'm talking about. If you haven't, well, it's to be expected, right? You're not gonna have like bam 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 fights every single episode, and this is what this episode is going to be. It's going to be very chill, it's going to be very calm. Not really a spoiler to say that, you kind of get the hint of where it's kind of going. In fact, I'd argue that the society actually really needed it at this point. So with that being said, you have to ask yourself, if it's going to be a chill episode, the majority of it is probably going to be talking and exposition and explanations, stuff like that. And as well, as the question is this going to be a 10 out of 10 episode, or is it just going to be quite of an average episode at that? Because that's my expectations going into this episode. But however, I'm actually more interested about how this episode is going to pan out now that we've seen the staff lists. Now, I don't talk about the staff lists all too much because usually I haven't got a damn clue of what I'm talking about unless I really know the animator in question. But I was very pleasantly surprised to see Hiramitsu back on it. And the reason why I'm excited anytime I see Hiramitsu on the project in general or an episode is because I know that there is going to be, or there's a high chance, I should more so preface this, a high chance that there's going to be added content or a really good script in general when it comes to talking points or character explanations or character dialogues. So I'm always excited to see especially those turn of events, and especially again potentially new content added into these chapters, which again we're going to have a lot of new characters joining us on this episode, and there's going to be a good few interactions with some of the captains that I'm really invested into seeing what gets added. Because as I said in one of the discussion videos that I did in regards to the OG captains, I'm really interested to see in regards to this situation about Unohana. Granted, I probably might not get it, but there's going to be a lot of emotions, a lot of shit talking, a lot of reality checks, I should say. So it's really going to be interesting to see how the voice actors, especially, but also the script, is going to be delving into this. So Hiramitsu is always a interesting one and an exciting one in terms of where the episode is going to go. In terms of the episode director, we have Yong Kun Jung. I forgot really how to pronounce it, so I apologize. This is his first time going to be an episode director, and it's most likely that maybe he requested to do this episode in general, and probably why he was an assistant episode director for episode 5, just so he could maybe learn the ropes. Now this is interesting because he is genuinely a great animator as a whole. Key animator, storyboarder, whatever you want to call it, effects animator, you know, he's probably dabbled in a lot of this stuff. He's more known for his key animation, but I'm very excited to see where he goes with this, because I feel like he wants to push himself to that next step, to being an episode director. Again, I could be wrong. Again, this is why I don't talk about animators that much, but it's exciting because, you know, if you are a fan of his or you've seen his previous works, he does some great stuff and he's very skilled at what he does. So I feel like this is the perfect episode for him to really delve into, because I do feel he has a lot of talent. However, he's not jumping in head first into something like that's a massively animated episode, but maybe more so a calm, dialogue heavy episode of which he can really like play with a little bit and make something that could be boring into something interesting. In terms of Shinji Itadaki, from my personal perspective, again, I don't really expect too much in terms of the storyboarding, because again, it's going to be mostly, you know, just talking and explanation, as we've talked about throughout this video so far. Some of the storyboards that they've done is something like for Komi Can't Communicate and even High School DxD, so you know, going based off that knowledge that I have, the very little knowledge that I have, I'm not too gung-ho about the storyboarding of this episode. I do feel like there's going to be a lot of pan shots, a lot of close-up shots, but I feel what's important for me in this episode is that art is on model and on point, and that emotion and music really carry this. As long as that's good, I'm not expecting character animation per se, you know, not on some like Chainsaw Man level type of stuff, but you know, if there is ever an excuse to do it, this would be one of the episodes to really kind of execute that. Again, there's no fighting whatsoever, so expression of characters could be really good for Bleach in this episode. So you never know, I could be beautifully surprised, and maybe that could be a direction that we go. So again, my standards so far, you know, are pretty low, So again, that's why seeing the staff has got me a little bit curious about how this episode's going to go. But let's talk about the screenshots, because the screenshots look great. First and foremost, we see Rukia with an eye patch on, because Meninos gave her that black eye, you know, gave her the left right good night. Again, she was camping. Ichigo, why didn't you see Meninos? I don't know, but Rukia looks happy to see Ichigo. I would imagine so, because you all pretty much died. You have Uke Take, which got slapped up by the looks of it. People are saying, who did Uke Take fight? And it's kind of, you know, the question of Weisel or Asking. Chances are it's most definitely Asking. I did pose the question of Weisel because of the hair, but it seems that like Kubo did go through a bit of a stylistic difference choice between the manga and then later on down the manga, so that could explain why I may have been confused, but I do believe it's Asking. But we didn't really get to see these two fight, so hopefully we get somewhat of a smidgen of a background of like why, or a flashback of why he's got a pad on his cheek. How did Uke Take get slapped? That is the question. But again, nothing really much to go on there. I'm just hoping that we get something at the very least there. We then do get to see Kensei. I know exactly what this scene is, and I must say, look, before this episode comes out, can we go easy on the Soifon fans? I actually really feel for Soifon, and I think it's great character development for Soifon within this episode. Yeah, she's going to be getting yelled at quite a lot in this episode. She's going to be spoken down to quite a lot, but when you look at the character of Soifon and you look at her as probably one of the youngest captains that have joined, you know, she's still, you know, a novice in the field. She's still not mature in comparison to someone like Komamura or Kensei or, you know, Shunsui. She's pretty young in regards to mentality. So I understand Soifon as a character, but I can tell that she's going to get a little bit bullied, I think, in this episode. So, you know, just a little heads up to all the Soifon fans. You know, keep your head strong. And to anyone that finds Soifon annoying, understand her perspective. That's all I'll say. But yeah, this is a screenshot from, I believe, Kensei kind of giving Soifon a bit of a telling off. So yeah, at least it wasn't the Komamura picture. Anyways, I would have actually died. That would have been funny. Next up, we have our first image of Isayobi. I forgot to say his last name. But yes, here he is. He looks great. Honestly, he looks fantastic. Yeah, there's no complaints here whatsoever. The lighting's good. And yeah, that's Ichibe. That's the GOAT right there. And I'm very excited to see how the other squad members are going to look. For some reason, I thought we were going to get a teaser of Kurinji for some reason. But yeah, I'm quite happy with Ichibe. So I'm very excited. Again, it looks great. Again, every one of these screenshots looks great as I expect it to. There should be no reason why they aren't on point. So, and then the next one, which I think everyone kind of loved, was this Ichigo one, because it is, and again, I'll always say in the live reactions and in the reviews, it's always nice to see an actual bright contrasted color palette for once, because we've been having these grays, a lot of grays, we've been having these dark colors, these greens, these yellows, these tints that, like, they're great in concept, but again, it takes away from a lot of the feeling that old Bleach fans got from the old series. So it's nice to see this color palette being used again, seeing our characters clearly, and just seeing them shine a little bit, because Thousand Year Blood War arc has been a bit dark and depressing, which it should be, you know, that's the point. So again, always nice to see this. And we'll just get into the description right quickly. Again, this is Google Translate, so it's going to be a bit terrible, but at various places in the Serate, where the Knights of the Star Cross disappeared, relief efforts were made for the injured. Ichigo, who visits Renji and Rukia, who were being treated in the 4th Division Barracks, is summoned by Mayuri to receive an explanation about the destruction of the Bankai. Itsei is accompanied by Ichigo, who was shaken by the story. Mayuri went to a certain place. The captains of the 13 Court Guard squads were all waiting for Squad Zero coming down from the Rieho Palace in the sky. So it seems to me we're going to get 3 points of this episode, one being all the captains and all the, you know, recouping, kind of healing, everyone kind of getting the relief efforts, which, you know, I hope we get a lot of realism in regards to that, even though I can't imagine there's much Shinigami left at all. But anyone that did survive, fair play. Then we're going to get the explanation of Ichigo's sword and talking about Bankai and the destruction of Bankai, which was stated here. And then we're just going to get a full Zero Squad appearance and a lot of dialogue in regards to them and the captains, which is going to be really nice. And I think, personally, the episode is going to end, let's see if I'm right, with Ichigo finally getting to the Soul Palace, and it's just probably going to have, just like it did in the manga, just like a nice overview of what the Soul Palace looks like, and then it's probably going to end. Again, I could be wrong, but this is episode 8, so I would imagine the episode after that is going to be going through the stages of getting stronger. So, you know, that's my prediction. Overall, I'm excited for this episode. Nothing too extravagant, but they have a lot to play with, a lot of creativity. So are we going to get a Shokugeki no Soma pan-to-pan, shots from the camera, or we're going to get some real good fluidity in terms of character, emotion, and interaction? We'll have to wait and see. I'm very interested to see what Hiramitsu's got in the bag, and Mr. Jung-Yung has to do for his episode directing for his first debut. So, that being said, if you like and subscribe on the video, I would appreciate the hell out of it. That being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fun. I've been Hanson, and as always, people, peace out.